Alrighty then. Hey guys, what's up? It's me, Priscilla. Welcome to another week of Inktober. I do apologize for being a little MIA the past couple of days, but I've been out of town doing stuff. I was actually at Walt Disney World this whole past week, and I had uploaded all my videos, but a couple of them didn't. I guess I just didn't upload them. I thought I did, but I was just looking at them, and I went onto my YouTube while I was in Orlando, and I saw that, these didn't get uploaded. Whoops. So I do apologize, guys. Now, let's talk about the theme for the rest of Inktober. I have had a lot of difficulty with with the prompt list this year, and I was looking at the last couple of days of Inktober on Jake Parker's prompt list, and I was just kind of looking at it and going, oh, this is interesting. This is a little bit difficult. So I think I'll just go off on my own. Now I think I'm gonna just do, this is a different theme. As you can see, I am using the watercolor paper Strathmore. Now you can see I'm using this actual watercolor Strathmore 300 series that's cold press, but I'm still using the same Winsor&Newton ink and treating it as a watercolor. Now I had been seeing a couple of people have been doing this where they have been drawing all these characters, but they've been using watercolor paper. They're still doing the same technique I have been doing, although it's still a little bit different compared to what I've been doing in my sketchbook for Inktober at the beginning. Now I'm kind of switching it up just a little bit and using actual watercolor paper and still using ink as a form of watercolor. I really, after working with this for the first time, this is the first time I have actually made something with ink on my favorite watercolor paper. I don't think I've ever done any kind of ink on my watercolor paper. So I really like how this turned out. You can just see how nice and smooth it is. And ink still has its own kind of style to it. You can still see it. And it does remind me a lot of watercolor on the paper, but it's just a little bit different. And it's a lot better to work on watercolor paper as opposed to the Bristol board that was in my sketchbook, in my Illo sketchbook. My Illo sketchbook is a heavyweight paper, so it can handle really heavy mediums such as markers and watercolor and acrylic. But watercolor paper, this is turning out really awesome. It really did turn out awesome. I'm very happy that I always had it in my mind that I wanted the last week to be on watercolor paper and still use my inks, but I couldn't come up with anything for the prompts for the last week. And so I think I'm just gonna go off and do my own prompts. I thought about doing maybe the Disney princesses, doing my favorite Disney princesses for the last couple of days of October, Inktober. I'm still participating, I'm still going. I may have been missing in action a little bit, but I'm still making little Inktober doodles. I just brought across a couple of little Inktober doodles with me and took pictures with them in front of the Magic Kingdom. Just cool rides such as Haunted Mansion, Toy Story Land with the Up House, and Cinderella in front of her castle. And yeah, but yeah, it's been a lot of fun. I'm still doing Inktober, it's just that I can't figure out the rest of the prompt list. It's okay, I want to enjoy the rest of Inktober. I don't know, have you guys? Leave in the comments down below. Have you just gone off and done your own prompts? I'm really curious to know. Leave in the comments down below. I hope you all have a most wonderful day. Oh, by the way, I got engaged at Disney World on my birthday. What? I hope you guys have a most wonderful day. Bye!